Brian, my brother, you guys have so many hits, iconic hits.
We're blessed. We're blessed to have, you know, the track record, the longevity. But again, like I said, we're talking about the music. That's where it really stems from. You know, if you want to have a career in anything, you know, it's got to be stable. It's got to be strong. It's got to be good looking in every way. Exactly. And I think it starts with the music. And that's what we've had from day one back, you know, long, long time ago, back in the 90s when we first started and just singing together, having that raw talent. And that raw talent comes out in the records. You know, I think it connects with the audience. And if we didn't have music, man, we wouldn't have anything.
The sound of Backstreet Boys.
Yes.
I want it that way, but we...
If you can, just paint a picture of what it was when y'all came together and y'all came across your sound, Max Martin, and rest in peace, Dennis Pop.
Yeah, man. Legendary, you know. I just go back to a bunch of young kids that, you know, had the same dream, that wanted the same thing, that wanted to, you know, wanted to work hard. You know, we wanted to be successful. And when we first got together back in early 1993, I was the last, you know, the last piece of the puzzle to really fit the mold, to bring what we needed. You know, we were missing that puzzle piece, and my cousin Kevin called me. He's like, yo, cuz, won't you come to Florida and sing in this band? And I was like, okay. you know, we got signed with Jive Records mid-94, 95. We got signed, and we got shipped over to Stockholm, Sweden to work with a guy named Dennis Pop. God rest his soul, legendary producer. And basically, you're isolated from the world, man. We're in Stockholm, we're a bunch of kids, and they throw us in the studio with these guys, and they're like, check this out. And I'll just never forget, man, the first time meeting Dennis and Max, and just being in their element, you know, and being an artist myself, you know, we all thrive off of that. You know, you are your own worst enemy in this business. And your best companion when it comes to the strength that you have of being around the right people. And Dennis and Max were the right people, man. They helped us hone in on what the Backstreet Boys sound would be for eternity. We started then, you know, and the impact that you make as a kid, you don't think, you know, you can't fathom the thought of, golly, almost three decades later, you know, we're still kicking, still making music, and still influencing the music world through good music, you know. And having that good foundation with Max and Dennis just really set the tone of where the bar needed to be for us. And little did we know that bar that we helped create would end up being a bar that so many would strive for in the music business.
You know, working in the studio with Max Martin, Dennis Pop, right? What was that one song you guys recorded that you were all like, oh my goodness, this is the one?
I'm a bounce around. I'm going to go to Quit Playing Games With My Heart. I was in the studio down in the dungeon at Sharon in Stockholm with Max, and it was just him and I, man. This is the cool story about it. It was just him and I was in the vocal booth. And he played me this song, and he was like, yo, Brian, like, you know, sing this real quick. And he plays this lick, and I was just like, I couldn't tell. Like, I was like, man, it grew on me really fast. But at the same time, I'm singing this song, you know, quit playing games with my jingle, you know. And I'm thinking, man, to be honest with you, Rich, I'm just going to be honest. Like, man, the man, I was like, you know, is this corny, or is this hot, or is this cool, or is it not? Like, I didn't really know, you know, and singing that song, man, and the B choruses that we did, and putting that record together, it was 3:30 in the morning in Stockholm. I'll never forget, man. I'm singing all the B hooks and the ad-libs and stuff like that. And a lot of people don't know, I actually sang that entire song by myself sang the second verse as well. And it was going to go on the record with just all me, but the label came in and said, hey, you know, we want Nick to sing the second verse. So we tweaked it up just before it hit the press. But that song in particular, man, that song in particular was just that sleeper song that you just didn't know. And it ended up being, you know, our first number one ever to just really put Backstreet Boys on the map. I can just name off a few that have really like impacted me personally, you know, like Show Me the Meaning of Being Lonely, beautiful, dramatic, just, I don't know, it's an emotion, man. I'm an emotional guy. And when I sing music, you know, I hope that the fans can relate to that energy and that emotion that's put into those songs. Because it lives, man, it lives forever. And yeah. the impact that we've had on, you know, the larger than lives and I'll Be the One, you know, Quit Playing Games, I'll Never Break Your Heart, As Long As You Love Me, wow, All I Have to Give. Like, I mean, the list just goes on and on. And yeah. And people connect to it, you know? So, man, music is the vibration of the soul, and everybody's got a soul. And if you can't connect to it, you got issues, man. You got issues.
Yeah, I hear you.